Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new here, my name is Toria. Today I have such an exciting video for you guys. I've been wanting to do a video like this for so long. So today I actually partnered up with DonaLoveHair to bring you this video. They sent me this cute little package to open for you guys and show you guys what's inside and talk about a little bit more about their products. And if you guys saw from the title of this video, today's video is going to be how to wear a lace front wig. So if you guys aren't new to my channel or new to my Instagram page, you see that I love incorporating wigs into my makeup looks, into my everyday style. I feel like it's so fun, a really easy way to kind of switch things up without having to do any damage to your hair. It's a lot more cost effective, and you just always have that different look if you're feeling like it for the day. This is a thing that I started getting into more maybe about a year or so ago. Originally, I was only really using wigs as part of my kind of Halloween looks and stuff like that. And then I just kind of started wearing them more recently as well in just like everyday kind of looks, just to kind of change things up. And I just feel like they're so fun. I've gotten really boring with my hair. I've just kind of tried to let it get healthy again and just try not to do much to it. So wigs were a great way to do that for me. This video is not sponsored. I'm not being paid to make the video, but I was sent the box in order to talk about the products for you guys today. And I'm so excited to say that DonaLoveHair also extended a coupon code for you guys to use on their website. I'm gonna leave that up on the screen for you guys if you want to purchase anything after watching this video. And yeah, let's get right into opening the box. So the color of this box is everything. I absolutely love the Tiffany blue kind of vibes. And I just feel like that's a really nice touch. So when I opened the box, I noticed that there were quite a few products in here. Even a couple more products than I even expected to be in here. First of all, there was a wig cap. And this one's like one of the netted wig caps that your hair goes into. I feel like these are really user-friendly and easy to use. And it matches the color of the lace. It goes really, really well with the color of wig that I chose. Also in the box, and which I've never gotten in any other wig box that I have purchased, but I did not get a brush. And I think that that was a really cool thing for them to include there, because you do want to brush out your wigs and keep them looking nice for as long as possible. So I thought that that was a really nice touch. It's like a tangle teaser brush. And just really cute with their little logo on it. And now for the actual wig itself, this one is this beautiful peachy pinky color. I think it's so gorgeous and so fun for spring and summer. And it's just kind of completely different than the other colors I have in my collection. And this one, it retails for $106. It's a 24 inch length. And it's a synthetic lace front wig. So it is heat resistant. You can style it if you'd like to, but I love the way that it's styled already. It's straight, but it has like a curve at the end. And I think that's really beautiful and kind of mimics natural hair the most. So I probably won't do much to style it in the future. I'll kind of leave it as it is. It is also really difficult to curl synthetic wigs. I tried it on my Daenerys wig and I kind of feel like I ruined it, because it's just like it won't hold a curl the way that I want it to, and I can't figure it out. I got tired of messing with it after like 5 hours one night. So being able to do different styles in it and like braid it and things like that, that's great, but I don't personally like trying to curl it. If you want to straighten it and make it more of a sleek straight style, then that's fine, but just so you know, it's really difficult to curl those kinds of wigs. It says that the hairline is a natural hairline. It's made with Swiss lace. The cap size is size average, so they don't have certain cap sizes. You can't choose it custom, but it does have little clips on the inside of the cap for you to make it a little bit more tight or loose depending on your head shape and the most comfortable fit for you. So if you guys don't know what a lace front wig is, it mimics your natural looking hairline because it is made with lace. It's not as it's not just like one stark line of hair. It's kind of varied throughout so that you can kind of see through as to where your natural scalp would be. And it just gives it a more realistic appearance. So I personally prefer in the wig realm, anything lace front, anything that is more of like even a full lace, I've never tried one. I hope that I get to one day because they're absolutely gorgeous and you can do so many things with a full lace wig, but they are astronomically expensive. So lace front is good enough for me. And I love it because you can do so many different styles. It looks so much more realistic than a typical wig. With my like average wigs that I've gotten when I first started buying them, the only way I can really wear them is by putting a hat over them, because otherwise they just look really, really fake. So I love having the ability to not have to wear anything over it, and it just looks like my natural hair. It definitely has a learning curve to it in order to apply it to yourself, but I'm going to actually show you guys what I do to do that and kind of how I style it after it comes to me in the mail to make it even more realistic looking. So as you guys can see in this close-up, the hairline is really, really nice. It's natural, but it is just a little bit too thick for me around the front edge. So I actually went through with a pair of tweezers and just like tweezed out little areas and just thinned it out in a little bit in the areas where I typically like naturally have a little bit thinner of areas. So like up here along my temples, I just thinned that out a little bit so that it wasn't so thick and uniform all the way along the edge, a little bit down here along the sideburns as well. And I did that very slowly, picking out like one or two hairs at a time. You don't want to grab a whole chunk of hairs and try to pull them out because you will rip the lace. So you want to be very careful with doing this. This, by the way, is only the second lace front wig I have ever gotten. So with the first one, that was kind of like my practice wig. So I felt like there were definitely things that I could have done differently with that one to make it look a little bit better, but I kind of, you know, learned what works and what doesn't. So hopefully this one is going to turn out looking a lot nicer. I also went through in the front because all of the hairs are the exact same length. This one does not come with baby hairs already cut. So I just zigzagged my comb through it, pulled out just a very tiny, tiny amount of hair all the way across my hairline, and then razored it off so that it was like very, very short, almost like about this long of hair, so that when I pull it down and gel it over the lace, it's going to look like real baby hairs. It's going to look more realistic, kind of like these little baby hairs I have right here. And what I also love about these is that you can kind of part them wherever you would like and you'll have like a really nice part. They're not super, super dense to the point where you have to like pluck out. You can if you want, but you don't really have to on this wig in particular. And so that's what I really like about that, is I can just kind of change around where the part is depending on the day and how I'm feeling. So now I want to go ahead and show you guys how I actually put the wig on. So I'm just going to take my hair down. I obviously can't have it in a high bun like this. I am going to try not to do my full application today because I did end up having to I took a shower last night and washed my hair, and when I do a full application and actually like gel everything back and like slick it back with hairspray, then I absolutely have to wash it again. So I'm really trying to avoid that right now, but we'll see if I can get it flush enough with my skin that I don't need to actually do those things. So I'm just pulling this back into a low ponytail. I'm actually going to put it into a low bun. I found that works best for me because, as you guys can see, I do still have like quite a bit of hair. And if I do it up too high, it tends to look really bulky on the top of my head and looks really unnatural. So I've just got this in a little bun here. It's going to go into the wig cap anyway. And so I'm just going to take the wig cap that it came with. I do sometimes use a stocking cap, but that one does really squeeze my head, and that one you really do need to use with like the full-on gel it down to your hair kind of thing. So we're just going to do it the easy way today. So you're going to make sure that the edge with the thicker part is going to be around your hairline, so that's going to actually go onto your head first when you're putting it on, kind of like applying a headband. See how the thicker band is at the bottom? And I'm gonna pull this up here. I'm gonna leave it over my ears for now because I want to make sure that I really, really isolate all of these baby hairs along the edge. And what I did was just tuck my bun in and pull that over my face. And now I'm just going to kind of disperse the bun so that it all kind of flattens out and doesn't leave a huge bump. Just like that. See how it's like a lot flatter that way? Kind of push it up. A lot flatter. So there's that. I'm just gonna pull it back a bit further. And I'm just going to push back any of these baby hairs. Hold this here in the front and then pull it behind my ear like that. And then when I let it go, it just pulls all those baby hairs back with it so that nothing is poking out. There we go. So now we have all the hair in there. And I kind of want to leave it so that it's just at the very edge of my hairline. Because my hair is so dark, I don't want that to show through the lace. So this is going to kind of mimic my skin so that I don't have to wear it like really far down on my forehead. If I had a dark rooted wig, I wouldn't have to worry about it as much. I'm just gonna let the bottom edge grab and then pull it up and over. And as you guys can see, it's a lot of hair. So I think actually what I'm going to have to do at some point, probably not right away, but before I actually wear it, I'm gonna have to go through and just like straighten the top part just to make it lay as flat as possible. So I'm gonna start kind of in the center cutting this so that I can kind of see a little bit better what I'm doing. Sorry if I'm out of frame here, guys. I'm just gonna work in sections. So I just feel like that works a lot better. I also heard that when you're cutting the lace, you should cut it in like a zigzag pattern so that it sits more flush with your skin. You're just gonna cut it as close to the hairline as possible and make it in like a zigzagging pattern all the way across. But just make sure not to cut off this yet until you measure it, because you want it to be able to go up and around your ears. Okay, so I finally got all the lace cut off. It's feeling much more comfortable, looking a lot more natural. It's obviously not glued down, so it's still kind of bumping up a little bit right here, but it's kind of hard to notice. I don't know if you guys can really notice it on camera, but if I look in my mirror, I can just see this little piece right here. But as you guys can see, like, I didn't even have to do any plucking in this part, and it looks really, really good. Like, that looks like a real part. So this is what it looks like from further away. You guys can see it's really, really long, goes all the way down to my waist here. And I absolutely love the length on this. So typically, you know, I'd put this behind my ear, but I don't have it glued down currently. But when I do, I'll have like a little flap here with some little sideburn hairs. I haven't trimmed them yet, I don't think. No, not on this side, I did on the other side. So basically I'll have this pulled down here and then it'll blend and just look like my natural hair, but it just won't be like 2 feet long. Yeah, I feel like this is a gorgeous wig. I absolutely love how it looks. And from further away now, I almost feel like it doesn't look too bulky on my head. I feel like it actually looks really nice. It looks like I have some natural volume. If I want to like zhuzh it up a little, I can. I really like that about these. And or I can just like slick it down, I can part it anywhere. I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how I actually stick it down to my head, because I'm sure you guys are interested in knowing how to actually do that. So let's go ahead and do that. So what I'm gonna do first is flip the edge of it up. And then I'm going to take a little bit of rubbing alcohol and a little cotton pad, and I'm just going to clean away any makeup along the edge of my scalp just so that it'll stick a little better. So now that I have a nice ring around my face, can you tell I only tan my body? Anyway, and I hope that you guys could hear that. It might be a little quiet, but I'm sorry about that. And now I'm gonna go ahead and get this stuck down to my forehead. So I like to use the Got to Be Glued hairspray. I know a lot of people don't like to use this, or they like to use the gel, or they like to use some other form of adherence. So I think this is all I'm going to use for today. So I'm just going to get pretty close and spray that right on the edge of my head. So I'm going to let that dry a little bit, and it's going to end up getting pretty tacky. I might have to layer it up one more time, but it's going to get nice and tacky so that I can stick down the lace to it and try and like kind of melt it into the skin. I'm just going to pull down the center first and lay it on the edge. I'm trying to kind of squeeze it down as much as possible. And then areas that haven't completely adhered, just go ahead and spray a little bit more right underneath. And then press and hold until they're dry. There's actually a second step I like to take, and that is to comb down my baby hairs that I've created and kind of blend those over that edge of the lace there. So what I'm going to do for that is take a old toothbrush and some more of this hairspray and just spray the toothbrush and pull the baby hairs down. I'm sure that you guys can see a pretty big difference between this hairline and this one here, where I didn't stick down any of the baby hairs. It just really, really makes a huge difference. All right, and there you have it. This is how I apply all of my lace front wigs. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Don't forget to use my coupon code if you do purchase anything from Dona Love Hair. And I will see you guys again in my next video. Bye.